Joining me now, as promised, Patricia Maisch. Great, thanks for your time tonight.
Thank you.
Just to start this interview differently than I presume all the other ones you've had to do since Saturday, what did the president have to say when he called?
Well, actually, I was on the phone with another media, so he had to leave a message. So I have the president's phone number. It was actually his aide or secretary that left the message, and I was very touched even before I called back, and she put me right through to him. I was just absolutely humbled by his words, and thankful and that he was so gracious and took the time to call me.
And I'm sure you appreciated, that's probably your first laugh since Saturday, and I know that was mine, so thank you for sharing that.
You're welcome.
Unavoidably, back to what happened. Your part began, I'm assuming, waiting in line to speak with the Congresswoman. Had you met her before?
I had met Gabrielle. My husband and I have a heating and cooling business, and some years ago when Gabby had a home down in the barrio, we'd done a bit of repair work for her, so I had made her acquaintance, and I had worked with her sister Melissa on a project, so I didn't know Gabby well. I know Melissa better, but I do have an acquaintance with them, and I find Gabby to be a brilliant person. She's a Fulbright scholar. She's so engaging and so non-judgmental and open to everybody's ideas. I just find her the perfect congresswoman.
On Saturday, did you have any sense that something was wrong before shots were actually fired?
No, I didn't. I was there early because I signed up, and I thought I was going to be taken in order of signing up, and so I went into the grocery store for a minute, and there was hardly any people there when I arrived, but when I got back out of the grocery store, there was quite a few people, I would say maybe 20, 25. Mm-hmm. So I just went to the end of the line and decided to enjoy the sunshine and listen in on what people were talking about. And I was listening to the woman next to me, who teenage daughter was there and had served as a page for Gabrielle for 3 weeks, I think she said, and they were there to get their picture taken. While they were talking, I heard a pop, and I'm not a gun person, but I knew without a doubt it was a gunshot. And at that moment, I decided I needed to either run or drop to the ground, because he had now, just in another instant, started shooting what has been told to me is semi-automatic. And just pop, 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 pop. And I did not count, but I decided that I was better off to drop to the ground instead of making myself a target, because he was already very close to me. He walked up and he was shooting at the people right next to me. The woman with the teenage daughter had shielded her daughter. I found out later she had three wounds, one to each arm and one to the back. I was just laying there on the ground, with able to look out of the corner of my eye to see the shooter, and I was preparing myself, thinking, I wonder what a bullet wound feels like and how much damage it's going to do. But instead, the gunman was now down partly on top of me, and I saw the colonel Badger, and that I didn't know who it was then, in Roger Salzburg, had flattened him. He's on his right side. I immediately got to my knees, and they were shouting, grab the gun, grab the gun, and I couldn't reach the gun because it was in his right hand, and that was the distant one from me. As they were doing that, he pulled out a magazine from his left pocket and had it in his hand, but he dropped it on the sidewalk, and I was able to recover it before he could get it. By then, the gun had been secured, and I noticed he was flailing his legs, and I was afraid that he might be able to get free, so I knelt on his legs, on his ankles. I did that for a couple of seconds, and then I noticed that Colonel Badger had a head wound. He was bleeding pretty badly, and I said, oh my God, you've been wounded. And he said, yes, but it's not bad. So I looked I was able to see it while I was still kneeling. I asked a young man named Joe to come and take my place on his legs, and I ran into the Safeway store, picked up paper towels that they gave me, and came back out and made a compress of sorts and held it to Colonel Badger's head and kept it there until the police arrived and secured the shooter and took him away. And then the colonel was able to manage his own bandage, and I did not see him again after that. And that was it.
And what all the events that combined to put all of you there, do you have feelings that pertain to some of the rhetoric that has been out in our political world of late that created this on Saturday?
You know, it's hard for me to say that. I dislike the partisanship. I dislike the rhetoric. I don't know. That man has medical problems, mental problems. I'm not qualified to say that. I would suppose he might have been influenced by it, but that's above my scope of knowledge.
Certainly what you did on Saturday was extraordinary and went beyond the ordinary responsibilities of citizenry in this country. So to Patricia Maisch, great thanks for your time tonight. And whether you call it heroism or not, great thanks for what you did on Saturday.
Well, if I'm a hero, then the Colonel and Roger are superheroes because they really brought him to the ground, and that took care of him, and the rest was just suspenders with a belt.